Oh, hello. Today we're going to start by creating a fragmented picture of an animal head. So if you start with file, new, then type your file name, document type, international paper, A4, and 300 pixel per inches. Okay, and you've got your document here. Now you're going to need to go get your fox and here drag it on the page on here. To be able to edit your picture, just click your ruler and click place, and now you should be able to edit your fox picture. So the first thing we're going to do is select the lasso tool, the one with the angle, polygonal lasso tool on here, and just go around the edge of your animal. So all the way around, and you can make slight angles on it, nice and quick, just all around the edge of the animal. All right, keep going until we've gone all the way around. There we go. We select the whole background and we've here double click to close the selection and edit, play. Right, now we've got our animal on a cardboard cutout. As you can see, we haven't got a neat background but a jagged edges. That's fine. This is what we want for this exercise on here. I'm going to show my rulers are showing on here, but if yours are not showing, click view and rulers to have them showing on the side. From the rulers, drag a tool, a guide, and put it exactly in the middle. Mine don't want to go exactly in the middle, so we're zooming in to adjust that. I want it bang on in the middle of the nose. Oh, here we go, and that's fine. Zoom back out. We're going to delete one half of this picture because we want perfect symmetry, so we're not going to need the other half. So clear this selection, then we go back to our polygonal lasso tool. Just before we go any further, I want just to show you we've got the magnifying tool here. We can use it to zoom in, or you can click the Alt key and click to zoom out. So on here, you might want to zoom in quite a lot of the time to be able to see what you're doing a little bit better. So going back to the polygonal lasso tool, we're going to use that again and select a series of shapes that kind of follow the natural shapes and colors of the animal on the picture. Same double click to close your selection, then go into filter, blur, and average. And it gives you an average plain color for this area. And you build that up by doing more shapes and triangle. I think this kind of fit the natural shape of the fox. Double click, filter, and you can see you can use the command or control K and F to repeat your filter, so you don't have to go in there and click filter average each time, blur and average each time. So going forwards, select another shape and Control or Command F if you've got a Mac or a PC, just the key changes. So on here, I'm going to try to select mainly triangles. You can select a series of different shapes, but I'm going to try to select mainly triangles because it's what's going to give me the best results in the long run. And Control F. Here I'm going to select this dark shape. Get this as a triangle. And the, some of the shapes I'm going to select as a different shape. So here we go. And Control F. So one thing to be careful is not to leave any little gaps in your picture. the quality of your end result is really going to depend on how accurate your selections is and that you haven't got any little gaps on there. So if you've left a gap and you want to go back, click edit, undo average, edit, step backwards, and that should get rid of your selection. So on here, you can also do it by Control F. If you look carefully, I'm just overlapping slightly the shape next to it, and Command F to make sure we haven't got any gaps on there. Okay, here, and I'm just carry on selecting, making sure I haven't got any gaps. So I'm going to fast forward this bit. Right, when I get to the eye, I click my lasso tool again using the same tool. I'm just going to follow the whole shape of the eye to select the eye, and same, I'm quite happy with the jagged edge. It is the effect we're looking for on this exercise. Select all, edit, clear. So we've got a hole where the eye should be. Fragmented half your animal, so we're going to need to copy this half over to get the full animal and the symmetrical shape. So if you go on your layers box on here, click on your fox and drag it to the bottom where you've got like a little sheet of paper showing. That's going to duplicate your fox layer. Then go to edit, transform, flip horizontal, and now your layers flipped the other way, so we've got the symmetrical effect on here. Then select the drag tool on here and press your shift key and drag it across until you've got a perfect match, and you can adjust it with your cursor, with your keyboard, and move the layer to this, here we go, we still got a little gap, one more, two more, here we go, we're fine now. So if you move your guide, just hover above it and you'll see this icon showing, and you can drag it back to the side to move it out of the way. So now we're gonna crop our picture to get rid of the white background at the bottom. So if you use the select tool here and select the area you want to keep, and then image, crop, here we go. So now we're going to give the background a color. So click on your background layer in the background box here, click on it to select it. When it's highlighted, it shows you've selected it. Go on the color picker tool and select a dark color on your fox. I've got this dark gray here. Okay, then I'm selecting the bucket tool out of my toolbar and clicking on the background to color the whole background. And that's it, I've completed my fragmented animal in Photoshop. Right, now if you've got time, what you can do is just play a little bit with the colors on your animal. If you click edit, or select, sorry, all, and then edit, copy merge, and then edit, paste. It's created a copy of your fox. I mean, my layer is here next to the background. I'm going to drag it to the top of the picture on here. And I'm going to go image, adjustments, hue, and saturation. And you can start playing with different hues to give your fox a different color. So on here, I've decided I quite like maybe a reddish fox. Okay, so I'm going to save my file, save, and then you've got fragmented animal FPSD. Select the folder where you want it saving on your computer and click save. Okay, then we're going to file, save as. I'm going to save a JPEG. And on here, I'm going to put red. Save that JPEG. Click OK. So then, as you can see here, we've got layers. So I've still got different examples of my fox underneath, and I could keep on playing with colors to have different colored foxes. So I also want to save the original fox file, save as, fragmented animal head, JPEG, make sure you've got it in the right folder, and click save. Okay, so now you've saved all your animal and you've finished, so well done. Just a few things I want to go through again on how to use Photoshop. So you've got the toolbar here, we've got the zoom tool. When it's got the plus sign in, it allows you to zoom in, and you can click the alt key and hold and click out to zoom out. If you want to reposition your picture to just see it full screen, double click the hand key in the toolbar and you've got it full screen. If you want to move your picture when it's zoomed in, zoom out a little bit, you hold your space key and that little hand showing again, and you can move your picture around the key around the screen. So space key, hold, and when the hand shows, drag your picture around to see different areas of it. Right, another one with the lasso tool. So when we select an area, we kind of double click to close and just click, double click. If you want to start a new selection, then double click to close, and you've start a new selection just by clicking anywhere on the screen and starting your new selection on top of that, and double click to close. Okay, so that's all I wanted to recap. The hand here, zooming in, zoom out, and double click to close your selection. Good luck, and thank you for watching.